Hello everyone, welcome to H&S Automotive, and thank you for taking an interest in this 2007 Dodge Caravan. So in this video, we'll do a walkthrough of this vehicle. I'll point out any imperfections the vehicle has, and then we'll also go over some of the major features and functions of this vehicle. So without further ado, we'll get started. At first, I'll just kind of walk around the vehicle, give you guys a general overview, a little bit about the history, and then after that, we'll dive in a little bit deeper. I'll just zoom out from here a little bit. So starting off, we did purchase this vehicle from an insurance company. This vehicle was sideswiped on this driver's side. So I believe the fender as well as the two rear doors had to get replaced. And these parts were taken off an existing Dodge Caravan. So with the same paint code, so there's no paint mismatch issues or anything like that. But this vehicle does have a clean title. There were no airbags deployed or anything like that. The doors do shut real nice, so that's not an issue. However, there is a little bit of damage to this B pillar right over here, and that was caused by the accident. So other than that, there were no other parts replaced. Once again, you know, it does have a clean title, and no airbags were deployed in the accident. All right, so from here we will continue around the vehicle with our walkthrough. So as you can see, we're coming around towards the rear, and then here we are on the passenger side of the vehicle. Alrighty, so from here we will move in a little bit closer, taking a look at the front bumper. The front bumper, there's no scratches or scrapes or anything like that. Well, I take that back. I guess there's a little bit of a paint chipping right over here. But other than that, I don't see much of anything else. This is just ice. The headlights are nice and clear. No issues there. And then also the grille, there's no missing spokes or anything like that. Taking a look at the hood. Hood is in very nice condition. Does have a little bit of residue right over here, but other than that, I don't see a lot of chips or scratches or anything like that. Now, this vehicle does only have 101,000 miles on the odometer, which is very, very low for this vehicle. Typically, we see vans around this year in the 200,000 mile range, so it's a very low mileage vehicle. Taking a look at the front fender, once again, this part was replaced. It was caught in that sideswipe. And then taking a look at the tires. Now the tires are basically brand new. As you can see, they are 832. So out of 10, that is very good. Still have 80% tread left. So we're good there. And then taking a look at the driver's door. Once again, this is one of the parts that was replaced. There's a little bit of, damage right over here. But nothing major, and this is not very flush with the fender. But other than that, it's pretty good. Moving on to the rear door. Now there's no dents or scratches that I can see, but there is a little bit of rust on the bottom. This is a very common rust spot for these vehicles, and it does go onto the rear quarter panel. Taking a look at other vehicles, this one is in very good condition for its age and mileage. Typically what we see is these doors are just all rotted out, but this one is actually held up decently. Taking a look at the rear quarter panel, once again, other than that little rust spot right down there, it is very good condition. Coming around towards the back. Right. The back bumper is in very good condition. However, the trunk does have a dent right over here. So that is there. But other than that dent, the hood is, the trunk is in very good condition. Moving on to the passenger side. Once again, the quarter panel is in very, very good condition. Other than this rust spot right over here, which is very common. Now, this isn't a major rust spot. You know, it's not like I can put my finger through it or anything. It is the surface rust at the moment, but it is starting. And then taking a look at the door, this one does not have any rust. Now this is the original door that came with this vehicle, so there's no rust on this one. On the passenger side front, once again, very good condition. And the tires are good all the way around, so I mean plenty of tread left, basically brand new tires. The front fender, another very common rust spot for these vehicles is this fender. Now this one does have a hole through it. Every Grand Caravan that we've seen of this year has this rust spot. We were looking at replacing the fender, but they've all got this issue right over here. All right. So from here, we will move on into the interior of the vehicle and check that out. All right, guys, excuse the dinging. But right over here, we've got the driver's door for the vehicle. As you guys can see, this vehicle is equipped with power windows, as well as power door locks, and then power mirrors as well. Here's an overview of the front seating area. This vehicle is very clean inside. We'll climb in, shut the door, and start her up. All right. So as you guys can see, we are behind the steering wheel of the vehicle. I'll go over some of the features and functions, and then all right. So on the left side, we do have the headlight controls for this vehicle. Then we also have the interior lighting control for the instrument cluster, and then this is the power meter control right over here. Taking a look at the instrument cluster right here. Once again, as you can see, this vehicle does have 101,000 miles on the odometer. Engine runs nice and smooth, transmission shifts nice and smooth. Mechanically, these vehicles hold up very well. It's just the body that rusts out before anything. There's no warning lights on in the dash other than that TPMS sensor light right over here that you can see flashing. It's just for the tire pressure monitoring system. Now, all the tires are inflated up to the proper level, so I'm guessing it's just a faulty sensor. So other than that light, sometimes it goes away, as you can see right there. Taking a look at the RPMs, as you can tell, vehicle runs nice and smooth. All right, zooming out. We do have some steering wheel mounted controls. We've got the cruise control on the steering wheel. On this side, you turn it on, and on the right side, you can accelerate or decelerate right from the steering wheel. Now, we do have some controls right behind the steering wheel as well. Those are the audio controls to either change the radio station, switch tracks, or change the volume. Right behind the steering wheel, we've got our typical wiper controls and turn signal stalk. And then once again, wiper controls. On the right side, we do have the transmission selector. Now this vehicle is an automatic, so, and the transmission selector is out of the way, as you can tell. Put it back in the park. And taking a look at the dashboard, overall very clean dashboard, no rips or tears or anything like that. Taking a look at the center console, have a few vents over here. We do have the hazard button right over here. And below that, we've got the audio controls for the vehicle. We have AM, FM, we have a cassette player as well. And then we also have a CD changer right over here. And then you can adjust your bass and everything like that from just right here. All right. So beneath that, we have our climate controls for the vehicle. AC and heat work great, no issues there. It's getting kind of dark. I'll turn the lights on. And then beneath that, we've got some more storage, you know, to put your wallet or your phone right over here. And then a much bigger storage compartment right over here. And then we do have two power outlets right here as well. I think this slides. Oh, yeah. Two cup holders right here. All right. And then just taking a look at the interior. As you can tell, vehicle was very well cared for. Interior is nice and clean. There's no stains in the carpet or anything like that. No stains on the seats. Very good condition. So from here, we will move on into the rear seating area and check that out. All right, so right here, we've got the rear door. Now this is a power rear door. I'm just not sure how to operate it. And climbing inside. So here's our rear seating area. Oh, before we do that, actually. So if you're familiar with Dodge, this vehicle does have stow and go. So basically what that means, these seats fold flat into the ground in that compartment over there. So when you don't need these can just disappear. When these are up, this portion over here doubles as a very big storage compartment, as you can tell right here. And this goes all the way across the vehicle. Go ahead and put that away. All right, so these are the middle seats. We've got captain seats in the middle. And in the back, we do have a bench seat. And even in the back, there's plenty of room. So space is not an issue in this vehicle. We got some cup holders right over here. And then additional storage right behind there. And then, as you can tell, rear seat is also in very good condition. Got some cup holders right back there as well. All right. I'll just climb inside. And like I mentioned, this vehicle does have power doors. And I believe you just press this and now it locked itself back. Press it again. All right. So as you can tell, power door works well. So we are in the rear seating area of this vehicle. Very nice place to be. Plenty of space. Space is not an issue once again. And then we do have some climate controls back over here. Put this to heat, and this is the blower fan. I believe if you turn it off from the front, it doesn't let the kids operate this. So also taking a look over here, got some storage for sunglasses right here. And then we have additional infotainment screen right over here. You can actually operate the doors right off of these switches right here. And then this is just for, I guess, mileage and what type of range you have right there. I'll just demonstrate the door, see if I can work it. Oh, there we go. Here we have the passenger side door opening up. And then I'll do the same thing for the driver's door. So. So as you can see, smooth operation there. Right. Let's climb out. And this is the passenger side area. Once again, very nice and clean. So from here, we will check out the trunk compartment. All right. So as you can see, we've got a pretty big trunk right back here as well. The reason it's so deep is because these seats actually fold flat into the ground. So these disappear as well. All right. So from here, we will check out the engine compartment. Alrighty, so as you can tell, we are by the engine compartment for this vehicle. I'll just be quiet for a second and let you guys take a listen. All right, so as you can tell, engine runs nice and smooth. There's no odd noises or vibrations or anything like that. We did replace this battery with a brand new unit, so brand new battery there, and once again, guys, thank you for taking an interest in this 2007 Grand Caravan. If you guys have any other questions or concerns, please feel free to contact us and we'll be happy to get those answered for you. Thank you very much and have a good day. Bye-bye.